In Bolivia, food is really, really, really important to them. Learn how to eat every single thing on your plate. Don't leave anything there. And learn how to be super happy with your food. Tell the people that make it for you thank you and how much you loved it, and you'll win their hearts. Because food is so important. And maybe like if you don't like food, like in general, like you're not easy to please, learn how to eat food so like it looks like you're super satisfied. Because that's like one of the most important things to them. So definitely eat all your food and love it for real. Love it. Because that's an expression of love to the people directly. And if you refuse to eat food, that they take it very, very personally. So don't ever refuse to eat food unless you're sick. Then yeah, you should not damage yourself either. Another thing is that when you enter a room and when you leave a room, you have to say goodbye or hi to every single person. So if you're a sister missionary, that means giving everyone in the room a kiss. Well, except for the guys, I guess. But and if you're an elder, like shaking their hands. I don't know. I'm not an elder, so I don't really know that kind of things. But when you're a sister missionary, you have to say hi and goodbye with a kiss. That's needed. And it's offensive if you don't. In Bolivia, they will find every excuse to have a holiday. They have holidays so often. I swear every other day was a holiday. They have all of these holidays that are like the no driving days where you can only walk, so like there are no cars on the road, which is really nice. I liked it. Or except for when it falls on a Sun. Well, on Sundays, it depends. If your area is small and you live close to a church, those days are awesome because people will still come to church. But if people have to drive to church, then that means your church attendance goes down. Well, they have a lot of holidays for different saints. Bolivia is definitely Catholic, mostly Catholic. And so they celebrate a lot of saints, days of saints. Carnival happens. Also, it's like a giant water fight. We weren't allowed to leave our house during 2 days because of that. We just had to stay inside. There are so many native people, cholitas, that's what they're called, that are in all of Bolivia. But in the city, everyone comes to sell. So along all the streets are all these little cholitas with their traditional clothes, with their skirts and their nice shirts, with their big hats and their braids. And most of them are super sweet and not super interested in the gospel. Some of them are awesome investigators. But yeah, that's one thing, the culture in Bolivia, the cholitas. Another thing is everyone is super late. That's like, I was late today. I'm still trying to get back into like American time. Everyone was late. I remember that was one thing that bothered me so much when I first got to Bolivia. My trainer was Bolivian. She did not think it was important at all to be on time for anything. And I was like, seriously, we were supposed to be at an appointment 30 minutes ago. What are you doing? And she'd just be taking her time. I remember at first that drove me crazy because I didn't understand, one, that that's the culture. And usually when you showed up on time, people weren't there. You had to wait for them anyways. Church starts a half an hour late. Well, actually, it depends on the area. But in some of my areas, it started late. Things start late. Always. Word activities 2 hours late.